Hello mates, I hope you're all doing well. So today I'm going to be doing another showcase and judgment. Well, I say judgment, I'm normally in awe of the tattoos and I'm really nice about all of them. But the intention is to do some showcasing and a bit of judging of some tattoos from various traditional tattoo themed Instagram pages that I follow. I've previously done two of these before if you want to check those videos out once these videos done. As before, I'll put all of the names of the artists on the screen as well as the Instagram handles of the artists so you can go and check them out if you like what you see. So without further fucking about, we all want to look at some sick ass traditional tattoos, don't we? So let's get into it. So first of all, we've got this really cool old school gentleman with a handlebar moustache and tattoos on his face and his neck. Got the word romantic above. He's got a really cool, very nice quiff. So obviously this is a really, really well done tattoo. I mean, my eyes are instantly drawn towards just how well done the moustache is. The line work is fucking great. Look how thick the outline is on the moustache. I would love to be able to grow a moustache this thick. He's got a slit in his eyebrow as well because he's a baller. Got lover tattooed on his face. He's got like a stretched ear as well. I love how well done the tattoos are that are on him. Like, check out this really cool skull. And then he's got, I guess that's like a butterfly on the front of his throat. Got a knife and some blood drips. Got an anchor on the face. The lover above his eyebrow that we already mentioned. That's a really sick eye as well, actually. I mean, the hair is so well done. Like some baby hairs here. The quiff's really well done. The line work is great. And then it's shaded really, really perfectly. I love just how thick this outline is. The shirt's done really nicely as well, actually. The great lettering as well. I mean, overall, just a really, really very nice tattoo. One that I'd be absolutely thrilled to own. All right, next up, we've got this cool, like, demon sea monster kind of fella. Like, it reminds me a little bit of the creature from the Black Lagoon. To be fair, that's a really iconic image. It's probably a good bar to aim for. Look at his fucking eyes. Maddening. Staring right into your soul. Imagine you woke up in the middle of the night. This actually is what my sleep paralysis demon looks like. Got this really cool forked tongue. The scales on the top of his head are so well done. A proper snarling fella. A really cool piece. One of those ones that the more you look at it, the more you zoom in on individual things, the more detail and the more nuances you can pick out. A really cool piece. I would fucking love to own this. Like, imagine this, like, properly blown up as a back piece. That would be absolutely sick. Okay, so now we've got this, like, paradise scene with, like, a rose at the bottom, a few flower fillers around it. Cool palm tree in there as well. A lot of colours going into this one. Got a bit of red here, a bit of orange, some green for the leaves, got some white highlights in there, a bit of white in the sea, blue in the sea, orange in the rose as well as red, brown in the tree, blue in the tree as well, yellow in the tree. Being able to use all these colours in conjunction together is what really makes this piece so, like, eye-capturing, what really draws your eyes to it. Such a really, really beautiful composition. It looks like it's on a leg, fits that area perfectly. Got quite a lot of white in it for a traditional tattoo. Some might say that's kind of sacrilegious, but it works so nicely for this piece, you know. Rules are made to be broken. This absolutely looks like somewhere I'd want to go on holiday, to be fair. I love the addition of the rose at the bottom. It's kind of a strange choice. You'd almost expect the tattoo to, like, round off at the bottom, but the artist has decided to include this rose, which is really cool. It's something kind of different for this style of piece. And a rose makes every traditional tattoo piece better. Everyone knows that. This is, like, traditional with a twist. I mean, when you look at it, kind of everything about it actually, like, is traditional, but it doesn't necessarily jump out as being a traditional tattoo. Anyway, we've got this cool, like, Grim Reaper, and we've got, like, a scythe around it, got some blood drips in there. What my eyes are instantly drawn to, as always, is the eyes. This red works so effectively, like, in the eyes, as if you can see, like, straight through, or maybe it's the fire inside. But I love that. I love these little details. Like, we've got, like, I love this line here that then goes into being the nose. It's like the contours of the face, but it also kind of looks like a crack in the skull. Both things are really cool. Yeah, real simple color palette. We've just got, like, black in there, red in there, brown in, like, the handle of the scythe. The scythe actually is done really well. I always love when this, like, wood effect is included in a traditional tattoo. This has been done really well. It's been shaded really perfectly. Look how deep and saturated this black is in the cloak. Some big old blood drips. Normally you get quite small blood drips, but This artist was not fucking about. We got a load of blood in here. Yeah, really cool piece. Next up, we've got this cool like floral collar with a rose in the center of it. I'm always gonna love like a really well done floral collar. It's not something that I would personally get, but I love seeing it on other people. And this is a really, really great job that this artist has done. What I immediately notice about it is actually there's quite a lot of clean skin in here. Like clean skin in the flowers, like they've used the skin as like another color. Clean skin in like the banner where these dots are, but then we've got this like heavy black around the flowers, got a bit of brown in the center of the flowers, bit of red in the center of the flowers, green in the petals, and it's that simplicity and the absence of color of like on the edges of the piece, which then makes the centerpiece, the rose in the middle, really, really stand out and look really, really strong. I mean, obviously this rose is beautiful. I love just how many leaves the artist has included. The leaves are really well done as well. Great line work. This black is so saturated in the banner itself. A really beautiful collar piece. Okay, so next we've got a hand with it holding a tattoo machine, tattooing the word love, few hearts around that as well. I really love this piece. You don't see tattoo machines tattooed on people too often, like unless they're tattoo artists, but this is a really, really very cool piece. I love the addition of adding the swallow on the hand and that the machine is being used to tattoo and it's tattooing the word love. Everybody loves love. The machine itself is really well done, shaded really very nicely. You've got like heavy black in the grip, and then pepper shading is used throughout. Got this really nice bluey green in it as well. I mean, something has gone wrong. I don't feel like flames are supposed to come out of tattoo machines, but maybe this machine is tattooing straight fire. I've just noticed, and I really love this like check effect that's in like the sleeve, I guess, of like the artist's hand. The swallow is so well done. Skin tone is done perfectly. Got some red nails. A really cool piece. Okay, this is a really beautiful piece, a really bold piece. You can recognize Samuele Briganti's work anywhere. Look how bold the colors are in this piece. So we've got a tiger in her mouth. He's just got, you know, a girl, which I've seen he's eaten. Or the girl has killed a tiger and is now wearing his head. Open to interpretation, but just look how bold these colors are. It's a pretty simple color palette, actually, to be fair. We've got red in there, we've got this orange in there, blue in there. There's a bit of brown dotted in there. Such a cool composition, though. You know, you've got the ferocity of the tiger mixed with the beauty of the lady. Look at her eyes. Traditional tattoo eyes, always gonna draw my attention straight to them. She's so pretty. And then this tiger, look at his eyes, look how ferocious he is. I'd love to get tattooed by Samuele. Just the cleanest line work, such saturated shading, such bold colors. A really beautiful piece. Okay, so now we come to another really great one. I love a Western theme in a traditional tattoo, and this is a great example of a great Western theme piece. Got this cow person with a shotgun riding a horse, and then a snake has come up and shot the horse. Got a skull down here as well. I love everything about this. Composition is great. I love the addition of adding the like rope as like a frame to the piece. Love the placement of flowers in like the rope border. All the flowers are symmetrical, which makes everything better. Birds dotted in there. So much personality in the horse. So much personality in the cow person. Love the bandana covering the face. Real outlaw shit. Just notice all their money spilling out as well, which is a cool little detail in there. This snake is really well done. The skull's really well done with all the cracks in it as well. Phenomenal line work. Real saturated black. Lord knows how many sessions this would have taken and the amount of pain the client would have had to sit through as well. But would have been totally worth it. Really fucking cool piece. Okay, now we have another really cool back piece. And there is a lot going on in this one. We've got an eagle, we've got a snake in there, there's a dragon in there as well. All of them intertwined in battle. My eyes are immediately drawn towards the dragon though, and just like, look at the scales on the dragon. Look at all the tiny little lines in there. It would have taken absolutely forever, I imagine. But then look how cool an effect it is. These claws are really well done as well in the dragon. In terms of the composition, obviously this is quite kind of convoluted, but it all makes sense. I love how the dragon and the snake are both like facing each other with the eagle in the middle. That's just like really aesthetically pleasing to me. Another one with some real crispy line work. Great saturated black shading. Again, must have taken forever, especially all these fucking scales and then all these details in the eagle as well. A killer bat piece though. Right, and then finally, we've got this like sacred heart with some knives going through it and a spider web right on the top of someone, the bunts. Got a few blood drips in there as well. I can't imagine how painful it must be to get like your scalp tattooed. When your hairline starts to go low, tattooing your scalp is a pretty great choice. Gives you the illusion of still having a hairline. I love this piece. It's so simple with just like various shades of black and how washed out the black is. And then we've got red behind that as well. A really cool composition with all the daggers going on and then the flowers, the blood drips as well. I love a Sacred Heart tattoo. Love the choice to add the spider web around it as well. Great line work, great shading. Great piece. And that is it. Those are my reactions to some really cool traditional tattoo photos. If you did enjoy this video, give it a like and hit the subscribe button and all of the other YouTube bollocks. If you like the music that you're hearing in the background, well, it was actually all produced by me. I've got another channel where I post beats / instrumentals that I've written for singers to use to write songs to. So if that is something that you are interested in, I'll put a link in the description below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.